Hello students, my name is Sampada. Welcome to class 7th and I'll be taking your class of mathematics and starting with chapter number 1, that is integers. So we have learned about whole numbers and integers in class 6. We know that integers form a bigger collection of whole numbers and negative numbers, which contains positive natural numbers and negative natural numbers and zero as well. Zero is neither negative nor positive. So all the positive numbers, whole numbers, negative whole numbers and zero collectively makes the integers. So we should be knowing what a number line is and how to represent all these positive numbers, negative numbers and zero on number line. So how do we start? We put 0 over here and from here on right side is for positive natural numbers, or we say positive whole numbers, except after 0. So this starts from 1, 2, 3 and so on. This arrow shows that these numbers go on up to infinite, and negative natural numbers are placed on the left side of 0 and starting from minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and so on. Again, this arrow shows that these numbers goes on negative side as well. So now we will be seeing that there are some marked numbers like this minus 3, minus 1, 2 and 3. If we need to place them in ascending order, how will we be doing that? So this is the smallest number from 0 to its left side. Numbers start decreasing. From 0 to its right side, numbers start getting bigger in quantity. So if we talk about the smallest number among these, then minus 3 is the smallest number. So if we have to place these four numbers in ascending order, we will be writing minus 3, minus 1, 2 and 3. This is the ascending order of these four numbers. So if there is any missing number in number line, you will be able to find which number is that, because after 0, again I am repeating, after 0, on right hand side numbers start increasing from 1, 2, 3 and they are getting bigger and bigger. And in case of negative numbers, on the left hand side of 0, numbers start decreasing from minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. They go on decreasing in quantity. So if I write 2 and 3, and if you have to recognize which one is greater. So we know that plus 3 is greater than minus 2, but in case of negative numbers, this sign reverses, like minus 2 is greater than minus 3. So we know the difference. So there are four rules. If we talk about operations in integers, like we have studied operations on whole numbers in our previous class, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So if we talk about those operations on integers, so there are four operations, there are four points basically. If we add two positive numbers, if we add two positive integers, we get a positive integer. We'll talk about how we are going to add it. We are just talking about the signs right now. So if we add two positive integers, we get a positive integers. And if we are going to add two negative integers, we get a negative integer. And if we are going to add a positive integer with a negative integers, with a negative integer, here we may receive a positive or a negative integers depending on which one is greater. We will see this through an example. And last one is if we reverse the sign again, which whatever number is greater, the symbol receives. For example, if 3, I'm taking example for the first case, if 3 plus 3 is added to plus 2, we receive plus 5, a positive integer, which is addition of both the integers. Example for second case is, if I am adding minus 3 to minus 2, these two integers will be added as 5. The answer will be a negative integer, that will be minus 5. And if I am going to take an example for the last case, that is one positive and one negative integer. So I am taking plus 3 and adding it to minus 2. So the answer will not be a 5, that they will not get added, because there is one positive integer and one negative integer, they will be subtracted. So here the answer will be 1, and the symbol will be of the greatest integer. So which one is the greatest one? 3 is the greater among these two integers. So 3 has positive sign, so 1 will also receive positive sign. We will see another example for this case. See, if I take negative 3 and positive 2, so again these two will be subtracted, because one is a positive integer and another one is negative integer. So these two will be subtracted and I'll receive an answer as 1, and the symbol depends on which integer is greater. So 3 is the greater integer and carries sign as negative, so answer will also receive negative symbol. We will practice more questions on these two. So here is a question we are going to practice based on the previous 4 points we just learned. So the question is, Mohan deposits rupees 2000 in his bank account and withdraws rupees 1642 from it the next day. So Mohan goes to a bank and he deposits, that means he adds 2000 rupees in his bank account and withdraws. Withdraws means he took out the money. He withdraws 1642 rupees, that means he took out the money, that means the money goes in negative. The next day, if withdrawal of amount from the account is represented by a negative number, see, they are also mentioning that withdrawal of account is represented by a negative number. Whenever you are going to withdraw some money or amount, that will be subtracted or represented by with a negative sign. Then he is asking, how will you represent this? So he added 2000 rupees and withdrew 1642 rupees, and we need to represent the total of these two. Okay, so this will be represented as positive 2000 and negative 1642 rupees. So this will be your representation of the above question. So now we will be seeing what is an additive inverse. What is an additive inverse of a number? So if I am writing a number 3, then additive inverse of 3 is minus 3. We will be multiplying this 3 with a negative sign. So replacing this 3, the plus in front of 3 is replaced with a minus. And if I'll ask about minus 3, an additive inverse of minus 3, then it will be plus 3. An additive inverse is a number. If I'll say an additive inverse of A is something which when added to A gives us sum as 0, then this number is additive inverse of this, and this number is an additive inverse of this as well. So whenever two numbers are added resulting a zero, then those two numbers are additive inverse of each other. Now, if we talk about general addition of two integers, like 2 plus 4 or of 3-digit integers, you know the drill, how to add these two numbers. We have learned it in 6th grade. So, this is all for today, and you will be able to attempt exercise 1.1 from your book. So, on the basis of this introduction of chapter integers, and we will be continuing this chapter in our next class. Thank you so much. I'll see you in your next class.